Hello students, welcome back to our zoology class. Today we are going to talk about another important phylum, Latihelminthes. This Platyhelminthes name commonly refer as flatworms. Platyhelminthes includes flatworms. Here we'll talk about the general characters of Platyhelminthes. See, the body is, why we call as a flatworm means the body is dorso-ventrally flattened on dorsal side and ventral side, both. That means here the body is flattened, compressed, dorso-ventrally flattened. Hence, flatworms. Important characters. They are the first bilateral animals. That means the body shows bilateral symmetry. Bilaterally symmetrical body, symmetrical, and acoelomate. That means here coelom is absent, body cavity is absent, and they are the first animals to show third layer, that is, or instead of third layer, I say middle layer, to show a middle layer, mesoderm. And this here, because of no body cavity, their body plan, we can say it's a solid bow plan. We call it as a solid bow plan. Here the body is made up of three layers: ectoderm, mesoderm, and endoderm. Here, most of them are endoparasites. Endoparasite, that means they live on in the body of other organisms, other animals. Most of them are endoparasites, and with some exception, that is planaria. Here exception, with some exception, what is that exception means? Planaria. Planaria is free living. Here the body shows, body exhibit pseudometamerism. Here means the body is externally segmented, but internally unsegmented. Hence, we call as pseudometamerism. Wherever the term pseudo comes, it's a fall. Metamerism is a segmentation. See, body is here, the digestive system is incomplete. Or before that, we'll say here, it shows, that means we can say it's a, it shows organ system level of, it's not a organ system, organ level of organization. See, already we have in our earlier classes we discussed sponges, cellular level of organization, then tissue level of organization, nidaria, and tenophore also tissue level of organization. Here organ level of organization begins, an important concept here. The body is covered with tegumented skin. That means thick skin. And body is in some endoparasites you find a structure called as head. That means here cephalization is seen. Cephalization begins from this phylum. Cephalization, already we discussed, it's a concentration of nervous tissue at the anterior end of the body, and we call this as a cephalization. Cephalization begins here. That means begins at anterior end. You find the body has got head we call as a scolex. And endoparasites, this scolex bears suckers and hooks. The head, we call this as a scolex. And scolex, because these animals are endoparasites, they live inside the other animals, like including human being. In human beings also, you find in the intestine. Like tapeworms, where you find the head region which we referred here as a scolex. And scolex bears suckers and hooks. For what purpose? Means for anchoring. Anchoring means to get attached to the host wall, to the intestine wall. Suckers and hooks. One more structure, a leaf-like structure called as sucker has got a leaf-like structure called as Bothridia. Bothridia is also seen in the scolex. See, Bothridia. Let me draw this scolex here. This part we call as a scolex. This is scolex, and you find here this is Bothridia, a leaf-like structure that you find at the anterior end of the body, Bothridia. So this part we call as, see, body is covered, divided into many segments here. Outside it looks like segment. This region we call as neck, and these are the proglottids. These are the proglottids, and this is a gravid proglottid. So in case of tapeworm, like the head region, we refer this as a scolex. Where it has got hooks and sucker for the attachment to the host wall, and the body is divided with the outside, you find the segment, in each segment we call as a proglottids, the mature proglottid. Because see, endoparasites will be having a high potentiality to reproduce. This is an example of, this is a tapeworm. or we can say tinea, scientific name tinea solium, proglottid. Okay, now other characters we'll see here. As far as digestion is concerned, here you find the incomplete gut. Incomplete gut, that is mouth is present, mouth is present, anus absent. Excretion is by the phlegm cells. A very important MCQs, or we can say another term, protonephridia. Protonephridia. What is the function here? To maintain the body fluid, osmoregulation. We call this as a osmoregulation. The primary function of phlegm cells is to maintain the osmoregulation. Then reproduction is by, here in case of, before reproduction we'll discuss here, you can see in some animals high power of regeneration. Example, we can take planaria. Very important MCQs. High power of regeneration is seen. Here, as far as reproduction is concerned, these animals shows hermaphrodite in nature. Hermaphrodite. That means sexes are not separate. Hermaphrodite or we can use another term here. That means the same animal produced two types of gametes, male and a female gametes. Such type of condition we refer as a hermaphrodite or monoecious. Monoecious. And development includes many stages larva. Here you need to remember these stages, like miracidium, sporocyst, radia and sarcaria. So these are the various stages you find in platyhelminthes. And here in some platyhelminthes you find polyembryonic condition. Apart from this, in some platyhelminthes includes many hosts for their development. So these are all about the important characters of platyhelminthes, and we'll see a outline of classification of platyhelminthes. So platyhelminthes divides into majorly three classes. Turbellaria divided into three classes. Turbellaria, Trematoda and Cestoda. As I said earlier, Turbellaria, they includes the free living forms. Example, we take Planaria or we can say Dujacea. And as planaria shows the high power of, they show high power of regeneration. Here the body is covered with, body is covered with ciliated, ciliated, body is covered with the cilia, covered with the cilia, and you know, a mucus secreting structure called as rhabditis, structure called as rhabditis. Here development is indirect, includes larva called as Müller's larva. Here the larva here is Müller's larva. Now come to this trematoda. Under trematoda, they are commonly referred as flukes. And here flukes, we can say here liver flukes and blood flukes. Here example, planaria or digestia. You can add one more here, or convoluta. Yes, come back here. Trematoda flukes, we say liver flukes and blood flukes. Liver fluke, we call this as a fasciola hepatica. This is liver fluke. Blood fluke, otherwise we say bilharzia or cystosoma hematobium, otherwise we call as cystosoma hematobium. Here important 2-3 important characters of trematoda, they are present, that means they are also endoparasites, trematodes. And here important structures, the body shows suckers here, two suckers. That means if once you take this animal like this, here this is one sucker and this is ventral sucker here. This is also sucker. This is ventral sucker, or we can say acetabulum. We go back to the cestoda. Under cestoda, this cestoda includes tapeworm. The scientific name tapeworm is Tinea solium. Then we say this is tapeworm, commonly called as this is pork tapeworm. That means those person who eat the pig meat, they will get a disease called as tiniasis. That means here tapeworm is commonly called as, here they are the pork. We say it's a pork tapeworm. The person who eat pork, they will get this tapeworm here in their body, cestoda. Then one more example, echinococcus is a dog, commonly called as dog tapeworm. And what are the characters that I discussed with respect to like scolex, head, all these things you find in this cestoda. So they are all endoparasites. And the body shows a syncytial tegumented body is covered with a syncytial tegumented body, tegumented skin. Syncytial means multinucleate. This is a characteristic feature. And here you find the body is pseudo-segmented. Body shows pseudo-segmented. That means outside the body is divided into segments, but inside no segmentation. Such type of we call as a pseudo-metamorphism, pseudo-segmented body, or show pseudo-metamerism. Body shows pseudo-metamerism. And even the body shows a pseudo-metamerism in the form of, like we say, that is divided into proglottids. Proglottids. Around 700 proglottids are present on the seen on the surface of the body. Only external segmentation, internally no segmentation. Such type of condition we call as a pseudo-metamerism. So the gravid proglottid or a mature proglottid contains X here. So this usually endoparasite has got high potentiality to reproduce. And here, as far as here also you can find the hermaphrodite nature, that means sexes are not separate here, and includes a larva called as Cysticercus larva. It includes Cysticercus larva. This is an important bit. Here, Cysticercus larva. Here, the larva, we say it's a Müller's larva in case of planaria. So, this is the outline, few important characteristic features of Platyhelminthes along with the classification. Here classification, as far as NEET is concerned, it is not required, but still you are supposed to know some important features and what are the classes that you've come across under the phylum Platyhelminthes. Hope today class you must have understood. In our next class we are going to talk about the next phylum, that is Nematoda. So keep reading, take care of yourself, all the best.